Okay, last video we talked about measure of center. This video we're going to talk about measure of variance. How to find the range, standard deviation, and variance from the following sample data set. So we have two data set. I'm going to do two examples. I want to make sure that you understand how to find the range, standard deviation, and variance. Okay, so let's just start with the easy one first. So the easy one, I believe, is going to be the easy one here. Finding the range. Okay, so range is basically highest range is equal to maximum minus the minimum. Okay, maximum minus minimum. So we're going to look into here, that is the maximum number and that is minimum number. So we clearly plug this in. So 10 minus negative 2, and that is going to give us 12. Next one, we look into the same time, we finish this one, range, okay, and clearly we're going to look for the big number. I clearly see the maximum number is 20. Again, it's not the last number, it can be here and there, so we have to look for the big number, and this is the smaller number which is in the beginning. It doesn't have to be in the beginning, it can be here and there, so we look for that number too. So in this case we have a 20 minus negative 4, so that will give us 24. Now we can come up with a conclusion about this one and this one. So seems like the range of the second data set is as twice or double than the first one. Or we can say other way around, we can say the first data set is half of the second data set. So based on the last conclusion, we can say some word. Okay, now the next one is very important one, and it's require a lot of attention also, how to find the standard deviation. Okay, how to find the standard deviation. All right, so let's do find the standard deviation. Well, in order to find the standard deviation, I have to introduce something here called the formula for the standard deviation. Okay, all right, so let's take a look what formula we're talking about, right? So this is the formula. Well, there are a bunch of formula in the textbook. Well, this is the easy one, I believe, to use the standard deviation. So first of all, what is standard deviation? Standard deviation is how much data value away from the mean. Away from the mean. So mean, we already know, we did measure of center last video. So we know that. Now we are going to find out that how far this data value away from the mean. So in order to do that, there is this formula, standard deviation denoted by S equal to square root radical SS over n minus 1, where this SS is sum squared, SQUARED, sum squared. Now SS, there is a formula for this one also. Look at that. SS equal to sum of x square and sum of x to the power 2, and this is the n. So we can find the sum of x, we can find the sum of x square, and we can find the n, then we are ready to find the answer. So let's start. So n, what is the first n? N is a sample here, okay, sample size, in this case 6. Some of you say in the problem formula, so in the formula, why negative 1 here? Why is negative 1 here, right? So negative 1, why? Because we are using the sample statistics. In the problem is clearly written, okay? I want to show you. In the problem is clearly written about the sample, okay? It's a sample statistics. This is not a population. We are doing a sample statistics, okay? We are doing sample statistics. So therefore, we have to subtract 1 to minimize the sample error, because we are not talking about everything, we talk about little bit off than everything. So therefore we have to subtract 1. Okay, let's actually work it out here. So let's see, we can actually figure those out. So we have the n already, right? Now we're going to find the sum of x. So let's take a look how we can find the sum of x. We can easily, or I can easily assume this is my x value. These are my x data set, so I'm going to put under the x as a vertical. So negative 2, 4, 2, 8, to 10. And I'm going to add this. It's going to give me a sum of x. How I'm going to get sum of x squared? I'm going to square all this number. Again, so negative 2 squared, well, you need to have a parenthesis. So it's going to give you 4 and 16, then 4, then 64, then 4, then 100. Okay, then this is going to give you sum of x squared. Let's take a look here. What we have. So if we add 10, 2, 8, 2, 4, 2, it should give us 24. If we add 100, 4, 64, 4, 16, 4, it should give us 192. Okay, so we are ready. So we know our n, we know our n, we know n, we know sum of x squared, we know sum of x, and we can just plug into this one here. Okay, so we can find the sum of x. Or let's do this here. I'm gonna do it here. So we're gonna plug it in here. So 192 minus 24 squared over n, in this case is 6. That should give us SS equal to, if we plug this in a calculator, right, it should give SS as a 96. So we have our SS. Now what we are going to do, we're going to plug into the formula. So we have our SS. Now we're going to plug into the formula. So this is the formula: big square root SS over n minus 1. Notice that we already have SS. That's the SS. Okay, that's the SS. So we're going to bring that down here. Okay, SS. So if you look into here, clearly you see it's going to give us square root of SS, which is 96, over n, which is 6 minus 1. And if you plug this in a calculator, well, let's have a calculator. We can plug this in a calculator. You can use this calculator or you can use this calculator. Doesn't really matter. Okay, so if I do anyway, second x squared and then 96 over 6 minus 1. Enter. So 4.38. Clearly, you see 4.38. 4.38. And absolutely, I'm going to use as an approximation because I'm rounding things up. So I'm going to say approximately 4.38. So that's how we find the standard deviation. So what does it say? These data values are 4 standard deviation away from the mean. Well, we can find the mean also. You add all of them and divide the number of number. Okay. So now we're going to look into the next one here. We're going to find the next one here. Okay. So let's do this one again the same way. Okay. We can look into this one. Okay. So I'm going to do the same thing. X under X, I'm going to put negative 4, 6, 8, 9, 20, 9. Sorry, I put already 9. Then it's going to be 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm going to verify it. And I want to do the same thing. X square. So I can square it. So it's going to give you 16, 36, 64, 81, 425. Now if I add this up, it's going to give me sum of x. In this case, it's going to be, if you add all of this up, it should give you 44. 20, 25, and so on, it's going to give you 44. If I do this here, sum of x squared, 16 plus 36, again, you can just do this in the calculator also. 16 plus 36 plus 64 plus 81 plus 400 plus 25. 622. This gives me 622. You use this calculator, you use other calculator, doesn't matter. It's going to give you the same 622. So once I have, and of course, my sample is same. My sample size is n equal to 6. Now, what is my SS? That is what is important. We need the SS, square root of something. No, not really. SS is sum x square, sum of x square minus sum of x to the power 2 over n. Again, you don't have to memorize the formula, okay? So you can just plug it in. So we have this one here, as you clearly see, that is sum of x square. So I'm gonna put down here 600. So I'm gonna put down here 622 minus sum of x, which is this one here, 44. Notice that there is a square on top, and n over n. Okay, so it is this piece here, that piece here. Okay, good. Now, if you do so, if you plug it in the same way in the calculator, it should give me approximately 299.33. Okay, so what is this? This is SS for the second one. Now we're going to plug it into the main formula. Okay, we're going to plug into the main formula. So we're going to do the second one still. We'll do the second part. Okay. All right. So S is equal to big square root SS over n minus 1. So in this case is big square root, which is 299.33 over 6 minus 1. And clearly, it will give me 7.74. This is the standard deviation. Notice that standard deviation, even it's similar with the range. Range was basically the double on the second one than the first one. So same as standard deviation also. First data set has a 4.38. Second data set is almost double. That much is spread away from the mean. Okay, now next thing, you want to maybe find out, you want to find out the variance. Okay, so there is a notation for variance. So variance is S square. Is basically you just square both sides. You square both sides. Okay, so S square is equal to 4.38 square. So if your S is 4.38, means your standard deviation is 4.38, you just square it and you find your variance. So you have calculator here, right? You can just say 4.38 square, enter, is going to give you 19.18. So approximately is going to give you 19.18. That's how you find the variance. Let me do this again here. 19.18. Now you want to find the variance here on that one down there. We can do the same thing. We can just find, remember I'm doing two examples, so you have better understanding. S square is equal to 7.74 square, and of course we can do the same thing, 7.74 square, enter, and it's 59.91. So approximately 59.91. And this is how we find the variance, and this is how we find the standard deviation, and this is how we find the range. As you clearly see, if you need to go back, pause, and come back on down there, and you can have better understanding how to find the range, how to find the standard deviation, and how to find the variance. And of course, this is not a population standard deviation. In population standard deviation, we don't subtract 1. That's the formula is going to be. So population standard deviation is going to be sigma is equal to SS over n only, n. So this is going to be sigma equal to SS over capital N. Well, because we are doing